Today I wanted to share with you a haul that I did at scrapbookpal.com. That is my favorite place to purchase lawn fawn stamps and dies. I will link them below. And let's get into this and I will show you everything that I picked up. The first set that I got is called So Thankful, and I love this set for a mini stamp set. It is adorable. I love the way they include this little leaf and this little twirly twine that you can put on the side of the pumpkin, and this explanation point for this sentiment that says so thankful for you. I think that's really, really detailed for such a tiny stamp set. So I needed to have that. I thought it was so cute. Okay, the next one that I picked up is called Trick or Treat. I also think this is a great stamp set for mini. I love the font on the Trick or Treat, and once I went through my stamping stash or my stamps, I realized I did not have anything that said Trick or Treat, so I really wanted to pick that up. Okay, the next one is for their most current release. It has been out for a while, so you guys have seen these before, but I figured I would still share them. How adorable is this little monster right here that looks like a bat? I love him. So this is really cute. This is called Monster Mash. And I figured this would be adorable to have for Halloween. And I purchased the coordinating dies with that as well. I like to purchase the coordinating dies due to the fact that when I do a Project Life spread and I include a lot of stamping and Copic coloring on it, those spreads can take 2, 3, 4 hours, sometimes a whole day. And if I can cut my time down by having dies instead of fussy cutting every little item, it really works out well for me. So I always buy the coordinating dies if I can. Okay, the next set I picked up is called Love You a Latte, and I do love this set. I've been into Starbucks lately, so I thought this was really cute for my Starbucks pictures and my Project Life. I thought that would be adorable. We've also been having a lot of hot chocolate, a lot of soup, and a lot of tea in this household now that the weather has gotten a little bit cooler. And I thought this was just the cutest set to have for the holidays. I also love the fact that the sentiments are like super, super cute and look like there's steam coming out of the different cups. And I think that's just adorable. I just had to have it. And then check out these cute smiley faces that you can stamp on any of the cups. I really like that a lot. That is so cute. And of course, I purchased the coordinating dies for that as well. Okay, the next stamp set that I picked up is called Spooktacular. I love this stamp set. I love it mainly for these little images right here. These are great for creating your own background, so I look forward to doing that. And I also think that this bat is super adorable. Another thing I liked about this stamp set is check out how small this Trick or Treat is. Sometimes when you're doing Project Life and you're stamping on a card or a picture, you have very, very limited space. So these tiny items here were really appealing to me. I thought they would work out really well. So I'm happy about that. So I picked up this set, and of course I also got the coordinating dies for this set as well. Okay, now this one is a little different. It's not from their latest release. It was from the release prior. This one is a beach stamp set. It's called Life is Good, and it has your crab and your little beach sand and a sand castle, flip-flops, a lot of ocean and beach-oriented stamps. In August, I went to my brother's beach house for 2 weeks in New Jersey, so I thought these would be perfect for the pictures, because once I went through my stamp stash, I realized that I did not have anything that was too beach oriented. Now, the dies I already purchased prior to this haul. I kind of did it backwards. I purchased the dies first and then the stamp set, which is kind of odd, but it was just the way it worked out. And I believe the reason why, because last time I placed my order with scrapbookpal.com, the stamp set was sold out and the dies weren't. So I figured I would get them because I knew I would eventually get the coordinating stamp set. So I am really anxious to use that. Okay, the next dies I picked up are the Stitched Hillside Borders. I do not have any hillside or border stamps to make little grass fields or snowy mountains or anything like that. And I love that these are stitched. Those are really, really cool. And the stitching is really popular lately. So I wanted to pick those up. And then I also picked up the small stitched rectangles. Again, that stitching that's oh so popular lately. Now, I did place a huge haul with my favorite things, and I will link you to that video below. It was my past haul, and their stitched rectangle hadn't come out. They have the stitched horizontal and vertical rectangles, but not just the plain rectangles like this. So I believe they released today with my favorite things. So at the time when I placed this order, they did not exist yet, so I wanted to get them, and I picked these up, and I picked up both sizes, the small and the large, because I saw how well they coordinated with each other. And how funny is this? Look how huge this package is. The last or biggest frame die is right here, and this thing is just like huge. When the box came, it was so large, and I couldn't figure out why it had given me such a large box, and then I figured it out. Okay, and then my very last item is the goodie bag. And this is made for doing Halloween treats or any kind of goodies or treat bags. Now, I'm not sure if I'm going to use these for Halloween because it is a bit on the smaller side. I knew that when I purchased it. It may be a little too small for the candy that I include for the neighborhood kids. I will give it a shot just to see how it turns out. But mainly the reason why I purchased it is for Christmas. I would love to give out my gift cards, which I do a lot of during Christmas time. And I figured this would be the perfect little baggie that I could decorate with a tag and go really crazy on with details to dress up a gift card. I do like cards that have the slots where you can put a gift card in it, but I really, really would prefer to do it in a little cute gift bag. And then I can add a card with it along as well. So I'm really happy about that. That's why I picked that up. Okay, guys, that was everything that I purchased from Lawn Fawn. If you have any questions or comments, just leave them below. Thanks so much for watching. Bye.